Hello guys, I have a lot of projects in my mind for future videos. Most of them need batteries, but good lithium-ion cells are expensive. Cheap cells coming from fake brands are dangerous. So what's the alternative? The simplest way is to salvage lithium-ion cells from laptop batteries. So in this episode I will show you how I test salvaged batteries. You can find used laptop batteries very cheap, or in my case free. All these laptops have problems with the motherboards, so the batteries should still have some good capacity left. And usually good laptop brands have good quality batteries. Even if a battery is rejected by the laptop, it doesn't mean that all the cells are faulty. If one cell is bad, the battery management system will disable the whole battery pack. This is a safety feature. Some laptops intentionally disable the battery after a certain number of cycles, even if the cells still have some good capacity left in them, so you are forced to buy a new battery. This is a capitalist world feature. Now we need to remove the lithium-ion cells from the plastic casings. You need to be very careful while doing this for two reasons. First, the sharp plastic edges can hurt you, so if you are a bit clumsy, wear some protective gloves. And second, don't damage the cells with your tools. If you use a screwdriver like me, be careful not to punch a cell. You will damage it and the cell can even catch fire. These batteries have not been used for several months, or in some cases more than a year, so I need to check their voltage. The cells that have more than 2.5 volts should be okay. If the voltage is between 1.5 and 2.5 volts, you can try to revive them by charging them with a very low current, around 200 milliamps. And you need to check if they get hot. This reviving process will work for good quality cells like these Panasonic ones, and only if the cells have good capacity left in them, but accidentally got over discharge from not being used for a long time. But if the voltage is under 1.5 volts, the cells most likely cannot be used anymore. Or if you succeed to revive them, their capacity will be compromised. Next, we need to disconnect the cells from the pack. Again, be careful, because these nickel strips can cut like a box cutter. If you intend to solder wires to them, you can leave a piece of nickel strip attached to the cell, so you can easily solder the wire to it and not heat up the cell. And now we have a lot of 18650 cells, but which ones are still useful? We need a good battery charger to test them, like this Opus charger. First, we charge all the cells with 500 milliamps or less. They are not used for a while, so they need to be slowly charged. This will take a few hours. You need to periodically check the cells. They shouldn't get hot while getting charged with 500 milliamps. If they do, the cells are not good anymore. When all the cells are fully charged, you store them for minimum 7 days, preferably 2 weeks. After this period, you check the voltage again. The cells that have minimum 4.1 volts are okay. They have a low self-discharge rate. If the voltage is between 4.0 and 4.1 volts, the cells can still be used, but they have a fast self-discharge rate. But if the voltage is under 4 volts, the cells have a very high self-discharge rate and you cannot trust them. Also, the cell's capacity will most likely be very low. Now we take all the good cells that we have so far and test their real capacity. We start a discharge cycle with a current of 700 milliamps. The cells will warm up a bit, this is normal. But if the cells get very hot, the discharge cycle should be paused by you or by the charger if it has this feature. When the cycle is completed, you can check the total capacity and write it on each cell. And finally, you can group the cells that have similar capacity. But let's say you don't have a professional battery charger, just a simple charger like this one. I'm going to use this phone charger with 2 amps. This means that each cell will be charged with a maximum current of around 500 milliamps. Again, check if the cells get hot. When the charging process is completed, store the cells. And after 1 or 2 weeks, measure the voltage and write it on each cell. Now you can group the cells according to their self-discharge rate. You cannot measure the total capacity with a charger like this, but you can check if cells of the same type have the same capacity. For example, these blue cells have the same discharge rate, so they can be used in parallel or in one battery pack. Next, you can compare cells of different types. You can start a discharge cycle and after 20 minutes, you can see the green cells have a bigger capacity than the gray ones. If you have enough time, you can compare cells from each type, and in the end, you will know which ones are the best cells for your project. Why did I invest so much time in testing and comparing these cells? Because I need the best salvaged cells for my next project. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.